There's a rustle and a whisper behind the skin of night, with a scent of limonene. As his knowledge coalesces, shrill girls giggle, then they shush one another as he hears them and looks around in vain to see who's there. And Jaymi smiles, for this kerfuffle is the opening of the soundtrack he's about to reveal. Next comes the chuckle of an Arcadian brook, on whose idealized bank Kim is reclining in the garb of a shepherd, blond and classical, contemplating how nothing lasts, nothing can be grasped forever, everybody passes and decays at last. Dawn glows pale at the side of the heavens, his flock is scattered peaceably around the field behind him, and blue through the air comes a call from that heifer lowing at the skies, an echo of a footnote of song via stone. Before this eclogue can wilt into two etiolated and idyll, Jaymi electrifies it by touching Kim's shoulders with a jolt of something new to him. Almost pre-physical, certainly pre-sexual, it's nonetheless an ecstatic ripple that runs through his body like a touch of the divine, as if from a figure leaning down from behind. A young female figure, he senses, for thus has Jaymi shown himself on this unique occasion. And this exists also, she seems to be informing Kim. Into his pastoral aloneness comes her touch, an intimation of her smile, and a promise that before too long, oh, soon, very soon, he will know about things he doesn't yet know about. Until then, she'll watch to check he's on track to know them, and she'll love him unseen while he nears that knowledge, so he may feel her breath upon his neck while she watches. She knows Kim will have to see horrors on his journey. She's sorry in advance, so sorry he will have to see that. So sorry that the other one will do that. So sorry they will leave him such an echo and a stain. But she'd hate it even more if he were not to break through to his arrival and completion.